Hi everybody, good morning and welcome to Digital Doxology. I'm Dave and I'm glad you're here. Today I'm going to do a short tutorial on creating the mood in music. And what I'm going to do is focus on minor keys and how you can use those to create some interesting moods in your music. Before I forget, please, if you like this video, hit the like button and also subscribe and ring that little bell so that you'll be notified when I put out new videos in the future. So without further ado, let's get started creating the mood. Hey everybody, welcome back. Let's get started. Today I'm going to talk about creating the mood in music. Maybe you want to create a happy mood. I like Snoopy. Snoopy always seems to be in a good mood. Or maybe you want to create a sad mood like this.
Hi, Chuck. Any news from old Snoop?
No news. He's never been gone this long before.
Poor Charlie Brown. He's always getting picked on, right? Or maybe you just want to create the mood.
Oh, come on, let's give him something. Set the mood.
Aye, look, I'm on it. I know how to set the mood.
Music, check it out. Creating a mood is an important thing to think about. Before you start to write a song, sometimes your mood that you're in will dictate what kind of song you're going to write. If you're in a sad mood, maybe a happy song will cheer you up. So sometimes you want to write a happy song to cheer yourself up. Writing the mood of the song will depend a lot upon your mood yourself. And so there are ways in music to create different kinds of moods. And today I'm just going to kind of focus on some simplistic moods like happy and sad and mysterious, things like that. But there are so many kinds of different moods that you can create in music. Don't get mixed up thinking that you can only write a couple of moods in music. Music can be full of different kinds of moods. And so, but today, to make this simple, I'm going to focus on just creating a couple different moods. So let's go ahead and jump in. I hope that you got your computer and your keyboard in front of you and you're ready to get started. Remember, at any time in this video, you can pause the video, rewind it, and freeze it so that you can see what's on the screen and practice. Let's get started.
All right, well, the last couple of videos that I did, I showed you how to play major chords in different inversions. And then major, C major. I showed you F major, G major, A minor, and so on. But today we're going to take a look at the four chords in C minor. So up on your screen, you're going to see four in C minor chords. So let's take a look at those. The first chord is C minor. This is, of course, root position C minor. Remember, root position is because the C is in the root or the bass. And it's different than the major chord because the E is an E flat instead of an E natural. C major, C minor. And you know, minor chords have gotten a bad rep over the last, hundreds and hundreds of years. People say that they sound sad. I don't know. What do you think? There's a C minor, there's an F minor, here's a G minor, F minor. How does that sound sad to you? I don't know. It's really subjective. Some people hear minor chords and they think it's very uplifting. So everybody to each his own, as they say. Maybe not sad, but melancholy. Serious, they sound serious. During Halloween season, you will hear a lot of songs that are in minor keys. All right, so minor chords have a reputation. Let's go through the four in C minor. And we're gonna do each chord for 8 beats, just like we did for the major chords. So 1, 2, let's play it together. F minor, G minor, G major, C minor. I think I played it 4 beats each. Let's do it 8 this time. 8 beats each chord. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, and 7, 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. And 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. G major. Now, what do you notice? I was playing them in block style. You can also arpeggiate them. Let's take a second. I want to focus on 2 chords there that are sound similar but are really different. The G minor. They have the same letter, but they're different sounding chords. G minor, G major. Now, in the key of C minor, you can use both those chords at different times, and they're going to sound just fine. Let's go to the next slide and take a look. We have 3 types of minor scales. The first kind, the most common, is called the C minor scale natural scale, or the Aeolian mode. And you'll see the notes there. 1, 2. The numbers that are written there are not the correct fingerings for the scale, but it's very similar to the C major scale. There are a few differences. E flat instead of E natural. Then you're going to shift to your thumb on the F. Okay. Last week, I think I showed you how to play the C major scale. The C minor is very similar, just the E flat, A flat, and B flat are now added. So that is called the natural scale. And you can actually play that scale with any of those other 3 chords, like this. Watch. I'm going to play the C minor, F minor, and G minor with the C scale playing in the background. So this hand, my right hand, is going to play the C minor scale and just kind of noodle around while I play chords here, like this. Kind of made a song up playing, just noodling around with the C minor scale and then making the chords. But it's when I get to that G major, that's where the other scales are going to come in handy. Let's take a look at them. On your screen, you'll see the C melodic minor scale. Let me play that. So the first 5 notes are always the same. Those are always going to be the same notes. It's not until we get to the 6th, 7th notes that it changes. So the natural minor goes like this. Then we have the melodic minor goes like this, which is almost like the major. Listen to the difference. Thank you. might sound different, but wait till we get to the harmonic minor scale. Listen to this one. So first five notes are the same, but six and seven are different. Recognize that? Does that sound familiar? Have you heard that sound before, that scale? That's used in a lot of Middle Eastern music, the harmonic minor scale with the flat sixth and the natural seventh. It's used a lot in Middle Eastern and Arabic music. In fact, let me show you something. I'm going to switch my sound here over to a combi, and I'm going to play a pad. This is called a pad, what I'm playing. And my keyboard has, the Korg has the ability to play all these different pads. But what's going to happen in just a second is I'm going to play the pad with the C, G, and C. And then I'm going to add the harmonic minor scale over here. Now, there is a composer, his name's Hans Zimmer, and there's a movie called Dune. If you listen to the soundtrack in the movie Dune, you're going to hear this a lot. Hans Zimmer used it to great effect. He added some drums, and then he would use the harmonic minor scale. I can use that scale right there to create a really mysterious mood using the C notes. Let me go back to piano. So that creates a mood right there, the C harmonic minor scale. I'm doing it here on the C, D flat, E, and F. The lower notes. And in this hand, in the left hand, I'm not playing the third. I leave the third out. Just play C, G, and C. And we can, that's called a pedal tone, by the way. When you play the notes and just let them ring. And then with the other hand, you can play a melody. You can create that mood using the minor scales. So what I want you to do between now and next week is just practice those four chords in C minor. C minor, play them in block style. F minor. G minor. For a second there, I started to add the sevenths, and you can do that. Let me show you up on your screen. I'm going to add a few other chords. If you have the time and you want to practice these, let's go show them to you very quickly. C minor, we did that one. F minor, G minor, and here's a new one that I haven't showed yet, but we will get back to that one next week some more. This is called an A flat major seventh. You can also play it like this. It's an A flat major seventh, although I'm playing it with E, G, A flat, and C. And then the next one is the F minor seventh. You can play it this way. There's lots of ways to play it. There's the F minor seventh in root position. Here's the F minor 7th first inversion, second inversion, which is what that one is. And then we have the G7th. C minor. So you could make a song up using these 6 chords. And I'll play through C minor, F minor, G minor, A flat, major 7th, F minor 7th, G 7th, So those are 6 chords in the key of C minor that are very useful and handy to learn. So practice those, practice making them in block style, practice arpeggiating them, or broken chord style. And last but not least, I'm going to show you some chord progressions that you can practice using the minor chords. Once you learn how to make the minor chords, and you can do it without looking at your hands or looking at where to put your fingers on the keys, then you can try the chord progressions. Like number 1, C minor, F minor, C minor, G minor. And C minor, F minor next, C minor, G minor, back to C. That's a nice chord progression, very simple. You could also add 7ths to those. And next chord, number 2, is C minor. Notice I took the word minor away. I just put a little small lowercase m. G minor, 7th. F minor, 7th. G7. There's the 7th. Now at the bottom it says play each progression, then using the notes of each chord create a short melody to go with them or complement the chords that you use. Note the use of lowercase letters to signify a minor chord versus a major chord. One of the things you will notice when you start reading music and looking at chord charts is that they will use capital letters. Just a capital letter by itself signifies a major chord. If you see a capital letter with a little M next to it, that signifies a minor chord. Some people will actually write minor or M-I-N period. That's the same thing. And some people will put nothing. If there's an F by itself, that's an F major. If you see an F with a little M, that's a minor or M-I-N. So just be aware of that and kind of watch for that when you're looking at chords and songs and stuff. So to wrap it up this week, I'm going to show you some ways on your screen, some ways that you can mix it up with major and minor. So let's say you want to write a song. Let's say you want to write a song and you want to create a certain mood. You can use major chords and minor chords independently, or you can mix them together, something like this. You can start your song on an F minor, even if you're in the key of C minor. This is an F minor. That's interesting because it's kind of tricks your brain a little bit when you start on a different chord. Maybe you start on an A flat major 7th. A flat, C minor. And then you can go to G minor. A flat. What I did there was actually a B flat or a G minor 7th with a B flat in the bass to C minor. You can add 7ths to your minor chords or not. You can use the harmonic. Remember the harmonic minor? Natural minor is very pretty. So all I'm doing with my right hand is just playing the minor scale along with some chords.
So mix it up, try some different things. And last but not least, I want to show you how you can use your phone to record yourself. Maybe you don't have a recorder at home where you can record yourself. I have a recorder up here, but not everybody has a recorder like this. Later on, I will do a video where I show how to use one of these recorders. That's a digital multi-track recorder. But for today, you can do it right on your phone. Get it. There's an app on your phone called Voice Memos. If you have an Apple iPhone, you can go in and look for Voice Memo app. If you have an Android, there's an app on your Android that's very similar. And then at the bottom of the screen, there's a little red button. When you get ready to record yourself, get your piano ready and set up like you want with the sounds that you want. Now I'm going to go back to the chord changes that I showed you a minute ago. And I'm going to make up a song using chord pattern number 1. And I'm going to record myself on here. So 1, 2, 1, 2, here I go. Let me turn it up a little bit. 1, 2, here I go. C minor. So now I can play my recording that I just did. And if you have a way to hook your phone into a Bluetooth speaker, it'll sound really cool.
On here. So 1, 2, 1, 2, here I go. Let me turn it up a little bit. 1.
Now I'm going to make a melody up to go with it. So you could have a lot of fun playing some chords and noodling around making up a melody. When you get something you like, then I guess you could get another phone and record yourself with two phones. Play the chords with one phone and record yourself with another phone. That's where multi-track comes in handy, see, because you can record yourself on one track and then go in and do another track where you record the melody, go back in another track and record your bass, and so on and so forth. If your piano has the ability to do that, you might be able to do it right on your piano. Check your keyboard and see if your keyboard has that option and ability to do that. I hope you enjoyed this. Hope you got something out of this today and you practiced this over the week. So please, if you like this video, hit the like button and also subscribe. And don't forget to ring that little bell so that you'll be notified the next time I put a video out. This is Dave from Digital Doxology saying have a great week, have a great day, take care, bye.